This video is about expanding and simplifying polynomials. Now, a few ideas are reviewed first before we start on the question. The first one is the distribution in algebra. If I have a multiplied by b plus c, I can distribute the a over a and b, so that will be a multiplied by b plus, there is a plus here, a times c. If it's a minus, I put a minus here. Or let's put it this way, a plus or minus, a plus or minus here. So the distribution can also be like this, plus minus c, a. So we can also, it's b a plus or minus c a. It can be written like this. The second thing is when you multiply monomials. Now, a monomial is a coefficient with a letter or several letters to certain power. So let's suppose you have a number, x to the power n. You multiply by another monomial, let's say b, x to the power m. Now, you multiply the numbers together, and then you multiply the xn by xm together. Now you simplify ab if it's possible, and here you apply the product of two exponents with the same base, and that gives you n plus m. The third idea we're going to use is when you add or subtract or you group monomials. You can only group monomials with the same letters to the same power. So, for example, a to the power x2, I can now let's say a equal to 2, for example, and then plus 3 x to the power 3, for example. Here I cannot simplify because the powers are different. This is x2 and this is x3. However, if I have 4x2 plus 6x2, I can simplify this. Why? Because look, x2 is the same x2 here, the same power. And then I can factor it and say 4 plus 6, and this gives me 10x2. Of course, when we do it in practice, we say 4 plus 6, but this is the main idea where it comes from. Okay, good. So these are the three main ideas we are going to use when we expand. Now let's start here. I have x minus 3 multiplied by this expression here. So I can distribute the x on this expression, the negative 3 on this expression. And I write this as follows: x, x2 minus 2, x plus 2. And then minus 3, let's put it here to have more space. Same thing, x2 minus 2, x plus 2. So what I did, I distributed x on this and 3 on this. And then the last term, minus x plus 3 square. Now we continue, and then we distribute again x over this and this and this. So x by x2, that gives me x3. X by minus 2x. Remember, when we say x, it's 1 multiplied. So 1 multiplied by minus 2 gives me minus 2. And then, so 1 by minus 2 gives me my minus 2. This x with this x gives me x2. Yeah, if you multiply x by x, this is like 1 here. It's not 0. Be careful. So when you add 1 and 1, gives you x2. Now x multiplied by 2, that gives you 2x. We continue, yeah? Now minus 3x2. Minus 3 by minus 2, that gives me plus 6x. And then minus 6. Now we have a term which is x plus 3 power 2. There is a formula for this. it says it's x2 plus twice the product, so 2 times x times 3 plus the square 3 square, and then you simplify it. If you are not good at retaining formulas, at memorizing, you can always expand it. So this is x plus 3, multiply x plus 3. And then you do the expansion. So that will give you x2. And then x2 plus 3x. And then plus 3x again. And then plus plus 3 times 3 plus 9. And then when you group this, it gives you this. So we go here and we put minus x2 plus 6x plus 9. Remember this one here? We got either from this or this. Now look, I have a minus, I put a bracket. Otherwise, it will be, if I don't put the bracket, it will be completely wrong. Remember, the minus is in front of the whole expression. Now, let's continue. So, we have an x3 here. Now, we can start grouping at least here. Now, I have, so this is already done. Now, minus 2x2 minus 3x2. They both are the product, they both are monomials with the same variable to the same power, x2, x2. I can group them, minus 2, minus 3, minus 5, x2. So gone and gone and gone. And then I have 2x plus 6x. Again, it's a monomial with x to the power 1, x to the power 1, same power. I can group plus 8x. Constant, minus 6. Now I go here and I multiply. Look, remember, this is a negative sign, but it means it's a minus 1 multiply. So minus 1 multiplied by x2 minus x2. Minus 1 by 6x minus 6x. Minus 1 minus 9. Now we continue. X3 is the only one, is the only term with power 3. So gone. Now we have minus 5x2 minus x2. Variable with the same power, we can group. Gone. 8x minus 6x. Gone. And then minus 6 minus 9, that gives me minus 15. So the expansion and the simplifying of the expression is given by, after expanding and simplifying, we got x3 minus 6x2 plus 2x minus 15. Now, while I was doing this, I gave a lot of details and I tried to explain every step, which is good for deep understanding.